Welcome back to Smart Family. It's a new year, and while you're making those resolutions to improve your life, why not take control of your health care this year? You're the only person who's going to be an advocate for your own health. And joining us now is author Barby Ingle, and she's also the executive director of the Power of Pain Foundation. Nice to have you with
us. Thank you so much.
First of all, I think it's really important that people understand that all doctors are not created equal.
Right. Every doctor has a different study, so you want to make sure that you get to the doctor that takes care of your condition.
For you, I know you had a car accident and had severe pain, and you've created a medical record for yourself.
I have.
Yeah, that's really important.
Yeah, I keep all my medical records in a notebook, and when I go to a doctor's appointment, I make sure that I bring a records request so that I can get the records from that visit as soon as they're ready.
Yeah.
And I can use those to give to other doctors that are helping me out.
Yeah, and then that way you've got it for the rest of your life, and you can document it, and you know where you've been and what you've been doing, and other doctors know that too.
Right, what medications you've taken, everything, what side effects.
I'm really impressed with that, first of all, that it's not in a shoebox under your bed like most of us probably do, so congratulations on
that.
Thank
you.
So there are some things that we need to do to prepare for that doctor's visit. And what are some of those? Help us kind of walk through and be our own advocate.
Well, you want to make sure that you know your condition. You want to make sure that you
Become an expert of your own pain?
An expert of your own pain and be able to explain it to the doctor. Use the words, practice using it. The pain is burning, stabbing, shooting, cutting, you know, the different words that describe it. Don't just say, I have pain everywhere. Be able to describe the pain here is this type of pain. The pain here is this type of pain. This one's worse than that one.
Yeah.
Those types of things.
Sometimes when you get in front of that doctor, you have such a limited amount of time that you really need to use your words wisely and be able to say exactly what's happening.
Absolutely. And another thing that I do preparing for the doctor is I create a summary sheet because doctors see thousands of patients. So I want them to know what is going on with me.
Like a walk-away sheet for them.
Exactly. And when you get to the doctor, they always ask you to fill out a lot of forms.
Right.
With mine, I can bring my form and say, see attached.
Yeah.
And I don't have to write anything out.
Right.
So, but on that form, I put all the medications I'm taking, what the dosages are, what any medication I've had a bad reaction to, any recent conflicts or issues that have come up with my care. And then they always ask you what surgeries you've had. They ask you over and over. So I put that at the bottom of my summary and just leave that on there so that
they always just have the same exact information.
Right.
Yeah. You know, it's important not only to be able to speak up when you're in these short meetings with your doctor, but also to really listen to what they're saying and to follow what they tell you to do, which a lot of times we're not good at taking advice and actually following through on some of this stuff.
Right. You and your doctor should be coming up with goals, and then it's your responsibility to go home and complete those, you know, your homework, you know, you can say. And if you, like, for instance, I have these bands, and they're different colors, represent different levels of exercise.
Right.
And if you're at home, you know, just take your 5 or 10 minutes and do your stretching exercises or whatever it is that the doctor said, and make sure that you are following up, doing your homework so that you can report back and say, this is helping, this isn't helping.
Okay. Let's talk about the medical billing for a minute, because you've got everything all in one tight place. A lot of people don't keep as good of records as you do, and then we also are not always the best at really going through all the fine print.
Right. Well, with medical billing, and I found out the hard way, I paid thousands of dollars that I didn't need to pay. You get an explanation of benefits from your insurance company, and you get the doctor's bill. Sometimes the doctor's bill comes before the insurance has processed it. So you see this bill and the amount, and you start paying on it.
Right.
Where if you wait for your explanation of benefits, you can see what they've charged for and make sure it's correct, as well as a lot of times it'll say you only owe your copay, which you've already paid. So.
Right.
You only paid $25, and you've been sending checks while you're waiting for your insurance.
So double check and make sure
you're really paying only what you need to pay, nothing more.
Very good. Thanks for being with us. We appreciate it, Barby. Nice to have you here.